Let's start with the output of that software. For reference, this is the result of the forward Euler method with a step size of half a day. We already saw that the Euler method with step sizes of two or more. But there's a price to pay for the stability of the backward Euler method. The code gets really complex as opposed to the code of the forward Euler method. You really do need pencil and paper to derive these equations. That's what we are going to do now. The equation for R, the number of recovered persons, is the easiest one. We'll start with that. And to save space, let me write underscore 1 for the current quantities and subscript 2 for the quantities of the next step. The forward Euler method would turn this into the following. The value of R, one step later, is the current value of R plus step size times the current rate of change, which is 1 over 5 days times the current value of I, I1 in my new notation. This would be the forward Euler method, but now we're concerned with the backward Euler method, which means that we have to use the rate at the end of that step, meaning I2 has to go in here. And now we're done. We know the current value of R. We have computed the next value of I in the lines before, and that's all we need to compute the next value of R. Next up is S. If we were using the forward Euler method, this would work as follows. The next value of S is its current value plus the time step times its current rate of change, meaning minus 5 times 10 to the minus per day and person times I at the current step, S at the current step. If we were doing forward Euler. But now that we're doing backward Euler, this has to be I one step after that and S one step after that. We bring this term to the left-hand side because we're interested in S2 and we factor out S2. So there's a factor of 1 times S2 and now it's plus this coefficient times I2 times S2. 5 times 10 to the minus 9th power divided by day and person, I2. And all that remains on the right-hand side is S1. And now that is simple to solve. S2 equals S1 divided by the very same expression that we've got here. I'm lazy, I don't spell it out. This completes the computation of S2, for which we need I2, but we have computed that in a line before. And now the equation for the rate of change of I, the number of infectious persons. Exposed persons, that is, infected persons, become infectious with a certain time constant, and infectious persons recover with another time constant. If we were implementing forward Euler, we would be doing the following. I2, the value for the next step, equals the current value plus the time step times the current rate of change, which is 1 over 1 day, E1, minus 1 over 5 days, I1. But now we want to implement the backward Euler method, which means that we have to use the values for the next time step in this rate of change. I bring this term with the I2 over to the left-hand side and factor out the I2. This leaves me with 1 I2 plus H times 1 over 5 days. On the right-hand side, I1 remains and H times 1 over 1 day, E2 remains. And now we can divide by this expression and find I2 equals the right-hand side divided by this expression, I1 plus H times 1 over 1 day times E2 divided by this expression. This completes the equation for I. The main message here is that implicit methods come at a price. Solving these equations can get very ugly. If you are convinced at this moment, you may want to skip the rest of this segment. Otherwise, stay with me to see how we can compute E2, which, by the way, is needed to be able to compute I2. A trick to find the value of E for the next time step is to look at these two differential equations in parallel. For the first one, the backward Euler method says the value for the next time step is the value for the current time step plus the time step times our estimate of the rate of change for the next time step, which is 5 times 10 to the minus 9th power per day and person times I2 S2 backward Euler minus 1 over 1 day E2 backward Euler again, not E1. And for S, the new value is the old one plus the time step times minus our coefficient, 5 times 10 to the minus 9th power per day and person, times I2, S2, backward Euler again. That's it. If you now form the sum of these two equations, you get E2 plus S2 equals E1 plus S1. This ugly expression cancels with that ugly expression, and we are left with H times minus 1 over 1 day E2. So this is what we have reached by now. E1, the current value, is known. S1, the current value, is known. We want to determine E2, the next value. At this point, we do not yet know S2. But luckily enough, we derived an equation for S2 before, namely S2 equals S1 divided by 1 plus the step size times 5 times 10 to the minus 9th power divided by days and persons times I2. And we have an equation for I2 that says 2 equals I1 plus step size times 1 over 1 day E2 divided by 1 plus step size times 1 over 5 days. If you use this equation to express I2 and then insert this result as S2, you end up with an equation that contains E2 and E1 and S1 and can be solved for E2. E2 appears in 3 places, and with a little algebra, you can turn the resulting equation into a quadratic equation and use the standard solution formula for quadratic equations. The result is what you see in the code. Hopefully, this is now really convincing that working with implicit solvers requires quite some effort with pen and paper.